Hi, this is my how to groom video on cotton like coat. This is a little puppy I have here. It's one of my client's dogs, so let's get to it. So this is a 11th month old pup here. This is like her third grooming. As you can see, this is very, very cotton-like, very fine, light hair. A lot of the times when we groom these types of coats, you see a lot of track lines on them. What I'm going to be showing you guys is how to not have them. She hasn't been brushed out or anything, not prepped, just straight bath and drying. So I have a couple things that I do. This is a solution I made with Les Pooch cream rinse and distilled water. So I'm going to apply this on the dog. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to blow dry her. The reason why I blow dried her was set in my conditioner solution, and it actually helps with the tangles. This conditioner, if you have not tried it, I definitely, definitely recommend. It does wonders. So she was pretty good with the grooming the past couple times. When she started, well actually she's been here like five times since she's been a pup. The first couple times she was very, very bad. And I'm talking about alligator rolling and nipping and scared of everything. So So it's a progress, so bear with me. So the grooming, I'm not going to brush her because the conditioner solution and the blow drying helps me set the hair and fluff it up. If I brush it out, it's going to lay my hair down. We don't want that. So what I have here, is my Libra. If you don't have these, I definitely recommend as well. Something I started doing was oiling my blades and my Libra before I start grooming. I didn't prep or anything for the video, I just clicked on record, so bear with me, you guys. So I'm going to prep her for the haircut. If you guys hear that, that's pretty loud. I just got these sharpened. I don't know. toe to foot. Just by using my pinky and putting it over the hock, and with my my ring, middle, and index, I grab the leg, and then with my thumb, the foot, and I push up on the kind of like a cat, and you push out the claw. But it definitely helps. And this is something that you do want to do. Keep checking your teeth to see if there's hair stuck in there for these types of coats. Once your coat starts to look choppy, it can be because of the hair being stuck in between the blades or between the teeth of the blade. I usually have the keyboard spray for dust. I like to use that and it blows everything right off. But I finished it yesterday. So I'm gonna be using a little toothbrush. So I like to use my thumb over the under the jaw, my index over the visor, and my pinky ring and index over the skull. So that way I can control the head if it tries to jerk it or whatnot. Okay, so if you guys know Vespucci and have their brushes, congratulations, you are winning in life. If you don't, it's okay, there's still a chance. Contact Victoria Blair, she has them. I got mine, I mean, all of my brushes. I mean, they are very, very, very good. Mattes, oh my goodness. I don't know. You guys have to try them, honestly. So brushing, when you're doing hair that's longer than 2 inches, start from the end of the hair and work your way to the base. It's something that a lot of people don't do, a lot of groomers don't do. And then you have nipping dogs. If you start from the base and you work it all the way to the end of the hair strand, you're going to be pulling everything out. Get little by little. So when I say that these brushes are magic wands, they are magic wands. Let me just show you guys. So she still has the little rubber band from the bow that I did about like 2.5 months ago. You see, this is very, very tough. Looking knot. I'll pinch the base of the knot. So that way it's not pulling her hair. I say one knot. Do this one. But I mean, honestly, what knot? So. I'm going to use a zero comb, but actually, I'm going to use an A attachment comb. I'm going to go backwards. Make sure it's on 40. So the base of the ear is right here. I'm going to go right over it. And also on this side. What I used to do is I used to touch the hair a lot with my hands. Don't touch the coat with your hands. Use your tools. So what I do is, if I do an A comb, I skip a zero, and then I go to the next one. So it's an A comb, a one comb. So you turn it on. My middle finger behind the base of the ear, index on the skull, thumb on the jaw. So this is where the Adam's apple is. Go right above it. The base of the ear. Turn it around. Relax. So if you're starting a new pattern and they don't have a jaw, a neck, the base, give them one. Okay. Relax. So then I'll go over with a zero. This is the shoulder. Honestly, you're gonna repeatedly be doing that. if you guys can see.
But in person, it looks pretty smooth. Okay, so continuing with the face.
These knees. I believe this is a 40. Two blenders have chunkers. Straights. And curved thinners. So what I do is I go over, I leave eyelashes. So, I know some of you are going to be like, oh my god. I'm doing it to where, stop. My blade is not facing the dawn.
know some of you might be like, you just defeated the purpose, you just went over with the straights. That's, in a sense, true. But what I use the blending, the thinners for, is to blend my line from up here, not down here. Okay? If you do not have chunkers, get some chunkers.
So this whole time I have my thumb and the jaw.
Also, what helps with the lines is for you to not go all crazy fast. Your clippers can only do so much strokes per minute or per second, whatever it is. If you're using like a 5-in-1 or the end is like a 5-speed, these have a little motor that goes around, so it's different. Pretty much the same idea though. You don't want to go fast.
this is a really good clipper. To help you do the smoothest of cuts. I mean, this isn't perfect, but if I would have had a I bet you if I was using my 5-speed, it'd be a whole different story, but how smooth it is. So I am brushing her legs out, just because I don't want any knots, as you can see. Well, I don't know if you noticed, when I was passing through the front chest area, it kind of snagged a little bit, as there was a big knot there. So I didn't brush her out from the top, because I knew that her hair from up there was very, didn't have any knots. And then you guys know when it snags, it's going to leave a dip in the coat. Good luck blending that in. Do not move.
shadow. I'll leave ears natural. If I see any little thing that I need to touch up on the face, I'll touch it up, but that's pretty much it. It's pretty much the control that you have over your shears. It's what's gonna help you get the job done. You just have to make sure that you know where you're gonna be cutting. I mean, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side, but I'm gonna let you guys go. But thank you guys for tuning in. But this is this is how I get these types of coats done. I mean, honestly, the video doesn't make give the cut justice, but you can't see the all these shadows. I mean. But if you guys have any questions, let me know. I'm gonna touch up her face a little bit, but for some reason she's backing up. Blenders, chunkers, thinners are your best friend with these types of coats. Thank you guys for tuning in. I'll see you guys on the flip side. And if you guys have any certain breed pet clips that you guys want to see me do, let me know. I have a Yorkie Shihtzu and a poodle, also a Chihuahua, but these guys are mine. Let me know what you guys want me to do on them, and then I can probably record it. Thanks.